And so here's what else happened. They, like I said, they end up shooting these police officers, come to my house without a warrant, assault me, commit a hate crime against me. And it was so bad to the chief at the time, you know, he had no control of this department, you know, and this officer had sought me out, this Reinhardt, the sergeant that caused this raid on my house, he had sought me out and on my job in 2011 at a Hallmark restaurant, and told me he would come after me one day. And this is the day that he used to come after me. You know what I'm saying? And what they did was, they covered it up. The lawyers that I had on my case, bro, these lawyers basically were working with the DA 100%. Everything I told them, they went back and told the DA. They visited with me in a room where the DA could hear me through a video screen, and they had a camera in it. They got a room called Room 4 here. And in that room, they have a speaker on the wall and have a camera. And so the DA can, you know, hear you through that camera. And these lawyers actively came to visit me in that room every time so that can happen. So yesterday, this other lawyer, Michael Ware, all of a sudden visited me in that room. So that's just so you grow and that I'm going through with these lawyers. But back to the whole thing about these no-knock warrants and the how they kind of act with the rights of the people. And in this case, man, humanity, liberty, decency, all this went out the window. And all this act was committed against me. And surely, two people who were just at home, where they had a right to be, sleeping in their bed, where they had a right to be, and the police decided that they were going to pick me, and they were going to attack my liberty. And they did that. And when they did that, the judges and everybody circled the wagon to protect this police misconduct. And I'm going to tell you one thing that I believe that city knows and that police chiefs know. And that is that these officers, this department, murdered this officer and shot these other officers. And, you know, I wrote the Justice Department, I wrote the FBI, I wrote the Texas Rangers, and my lawyers have did none of that. You know what I mean? They, you know, they did none of that. And, you know, I'm going to tell you, man, you know, it's just, you know, I believe that I'm going to go through the same thing here with these paid lawyers that I went through with these other lawyers not wanting to investigate the case. And what I believe is that these lawyers are going to take the paperwork of the other lawyers based on a failed defense that they were applying for me, doing for me, and try to use that defense to go, you know, go on down the range of injustice. You know what I mean? And so I told them I reject that defense, and I told them that, you know, everything that was going wrong. But, man, you know, like I say, man, you know, like I say, they want to put this on me, put this murder on me. When, you know, I ain't shot nobody, you know what I'm saying? And so they didn't do a thorough investigation because, like I've always said, they didn't investigate on this case, saying that he didn't trust their story, that there were lies told, that they violated policy. And even out here that one of the officers, was really disciplined for this. And like I said, but the police said they saw out of their own eyes, they took these reports and they changed the report. They tampered with the DVDs, cut all the DVDs down to two, three seconds, you know, 20, 30 seconds. You know, that's what they did to the DVDs, and they destroyed information in my case. And that happens all over the country. You know, when you look at the case in North Carolina, this guy just got his brain throughout. You look at what they're saying. That man, they tampered with the DVDs. You know, and they won't release information. And so, you know, we both be a society, man, that have liberties and justice. And it don't seem like that's working, man. These no-knock warrants is another way for the police to terrorize you. Let's keep it 100. That's what it is. And that's why they like to do it, because like I said, they don't have to be accountable for them doing these warrants. They don't have to, they do shortcuts. These warrants are never fully vetted. There's no crime being committed at the house. They're not finding evidence of any crime in these houses. You know, you look at the Reed case, right in the lane. They raided his house just like they raided mine, and they killed him. And they found no drugs in his house. They came to raid my house, claiming that there was drugs in my house and that I was selling drugs, but they found no drugs in my house. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
And so, yeah, there's something going on. And then, let me tell you this. Even when the police are wrong, they can go to the judge, and the judge can cover for them. Just like in my case, I believe that. You know, I believe this warrant and all this stuff was perpetrated on me. After these people did this search warrant on my house, and they knew they were wrong, and they killed this officer, and it was totally covered up. And that's why they don't got no chief. That's why they changed the chief. You know what I'm saying? The police. And but that board in Killeen showed great courage and honor for that officer did with him. And his family deserved that. And the way that he's been treated. And I'm so shocked that it's been 7 years. And I don't know what they told his family. You know, but I can tell you 100% for sure that where the police say they saw them when he get shot was under the stairs, left of the front door, that's what the police officer at the car said. They turned around, and that's what they saw. Him fall to the ground, left for the front door. That's the place that, where I was shooting, I could not shoot him. You have Officer McNown actually seeing the officer fall, left for the front door, and saying it, and calling it the kill zone, where he saw the officer get killed at, left for the front door. The officer, McNown, was the officer who ran to the front door and grabbed him and pulled him from under the stairs around the corner. You understand what I'm saying? You have Officer Otis Denton, who was shot under the stairs, who said that the officer did what he just a few feet in front of him, left the front door. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
You got another officer that got shot under the stairs. And there was Dan Dykes. He got shot from what he said right in front of the living room window. You know, so you got three officers that were shot under the stairs, a place where I couldn't shoot. Then you have another officer, Major Clark, the officer that busted my room window, said in the report that he had his back against the wall when he busted the window. Right? And he said he seen two flashes come out the window, and at some point, he felt a blast in his chest. He said, it knocked him down, he was out of breath, he rolled, and he got out of the crossfire, and he tripped on the only thing under the stairs. Now, they were shooting in the interior. They were shooting in the interior of the park where they were at. And so, you know, I'm just saying, all this right here, I got paperwork. I think I sent it to you. People can go online and see these reports and read it for themselves. Read the Now's report. Read Kirk's report, who said that there was a crossfire. Read the Now's report. It says he east of Killzone. That was the next, the east was the apartment next door. They call my apartment west. They call the next door apartment east. You know, read these police reports and understand they're telling you what really happened. But the DA took all those reports and changed, took all they, all these reports. Now, I know that because I got the reports from Carlos, and I can see the reports that I got from my other attorney were different from the reports that the DA gave him. So the DA is allowed to clean up what they want to clean up. And that's not how it's supposed to be. You know, and time to time again, innocent people are put on death row without fair trial, because these DAs and these judges, you know, if you are acting fair, believe that you don't deserve no rights. You know, and that's what they said about my case. That I don't deserve to be judged by the law. They even indicted me as under a terroristic threat for being at home in my bed. You know what I'm saying? You know, and like right. I said, everybody's telling me to give these lawyers a chance. Give these lawyers a chance. But man, you know, a lot of these lawyers have so many different cases, and a lot of times, it's hard for them to even be effective on any one case. And so, they don't want these out-of-state attorneys on my case. It's what I'm getting from this lawyer, Michael Ware, from talking to him yesterday. You know, I have a way of talking to a lawyer and filling him out. And the way he was telling me, the way that I was getting it is, they want these out-of-state attorneys on the case. You know, he's supposed to be my lawyer. And he's telling me all the reasons and giving me these rules of law that have nothing to do with these attorneys being on my case. You understand? And so I didn't understand that. Why are you telling me that an attorney can't study law and you come to this state and study law? And that's not what this is. They're applying to assist on the case. You understand? That's
right.
A whole different thing. That's a whole different thing from practicing and studying the law. Because they're merging with a firm to assist in, assisting on the case. And so, they try to, when you don't know the law, then you would go for this, but you think your attorney wouldn't be saying this to you unless he had an issue where he met with the prosecutors, which he did prior. And, you know, he didn't supposed to meet with them. He's supposed to file most. You know, I want transparency. You know, I don't want the same old. You know, if you want, go meet with the prosecutor behind my back and let him tell you about, oh, he talks on the phone, he does this, he does that. And, you know, and meet with my old prior attorneys and they say, oh, he's crazy or he's this. He just, that, it puts in your mind a vision and it causes a defending, and then you start doing the same thing that they did. And so, you know, it hurts me, man, to, you know, and see, I know this. I know this. I can smell a rat a mile away. You know, and like I said, how did you end up on my case? You know, I had no say so in the matter. But the professors at the University of Texas told me that they suggested he be my lawyer because my lawyer, Justin Moore, had no experience. And that he's only been a lawyer for 7 years. And so they suggested this guy. But how is it they suggested a lawyer who had a case overturned in a judge's courtroom? This judge did him a favor. This judge did not overturn that conviction. Even though it was foul play, and the judge did the right thing as far as overturning that conviction. But it's an unwritten rule between judges and lawyers. When a judge does you a favor, he's not going to tell you you owe me a favor, but you're going to feel obligated to return that favor. You know, and a person who don't know nothing about the judicial system and don't know how the game goes and how they playing in this arena, it's a blood sport. You know what I'm saying? And so now, my position is, hey, you on this case to return the favor. And you can even be accepting funds from the other side. You know, I'm not saying that's the case, but I believe you could only get the double crossing. And I should have had to say so. Somebody should have asked me, hey man, this lawyer, you know, do you want to accept this lawyer, you want to try to find somebody else? I would couldn't say find somebody else because it's a conflict here. You know. But yeah, man, you know, so you know, they ducking my calls right now. You know, they don't wanna talk to me because, you know, I'm a tough ID. You know.
Right.
And, you know, like I said, they don't want these two DC lawyers on my case. And the problem is I've taken lawyers assisting on cases before. You know, what are they trying to hide? You know what I'm saying? That gives us more investigative power because the lawyers are in D.C. You know, that helps us out a lot to try to uncover this injustice that they're doing to the Dinwiddie family, Mrs. Dinwiddie, and what they did to her husband is really bad. And they do owe her, they do owe this family more than they gave this family. They sent her husband over there without a warrant. He ends up getting shot and killed in the crossfire. And like I said, I don't know what they told her, but she needs to get an investigator to find out what happened to her husband. What exactly happened. You know, what exactly happened. I also don't just give up and settle for what they're saying.
Right.
You know. So, yeah, you know. So, man, you know, I'm going to call you back one more time, man. I just-